The biggest impact on me from LTC was the realization of how small and interwoven our community is in Thurston County. Everybody knows everybody eventually, and I definitely felt like I knew a lot more people after this and how they were connected and how I could be connected with them.
Definitely the field trips, getting to see all kinds of industries all throughout Thurston County, getting to see a trout farm, for instance, or bottling and canning, getting to see where some of the best coffee in our county is roasted and distributed. There were so many different places that I don't think I would have gone if I wasn't in this program, and it helped give me a really broad perspective of all of the industry and economic elements that are thriving in our county.
I think it was the arts and just how important arts are to a vibrant community, and really how diverse and deep the arts community here is in Olympia.
I think the poverty simulation exercise really stuck with me, that I would find myself in the community and places going, how hard would this be to do if I didn't have a car or childcare, or if I didn't speak the language and had a hard time advocating for myself? That has stayed with me a really long time.
I think the biggest impact on me was the homework that we did for Home Equity Day and the reading about white privilege, and I just took for granted the things that were available to me that maybe weren't available to others. It was kind of an eye-opener.
I was so excited when I found out that Dr. Johnson was going to be there. I was kind of fangirling about it, actually, and just what an incredible woman and inspiring speaker, and Parfait as well that day. Equity Day helped me see what I didn't know. And I've spent a lot of time since then striving to improve.
Every day was really unique, but something that really struck me was Law and Justice Day. I think oftentimes we glorify things through media, and actually seeing how our justice system works and the things that we can keep improving on was really beneficial, because I think we have a national narrative, and then seeing what's actually happening in our community and how we can be a part of it was really impactful for me.
I had the opportunity to ride along with the patrol sergeant, and getting the opportunity to ask him questions and hear about their challenges, which is obviously kind of a big deal right now in our community, was really an amazing experience.
I think it would be the cohort of people. It was great to go through it together, and then it's such a diverse group of people coming together, not necessarily just in demographics, but then looking at the fields in which people are coming, public, private sector, nonprofit, and it was really nice to go through the experience and then talk to folks about what it was like for them and what challenges or what thoughts it brought up.
Just the instant kinship that we have right when we all get together, and then over the course of the 10 months has been building those relationships, getting to know people, and just being that sponge of all the knowledge and just everything that they all bring to the table. So I'd say building relationships is foremost, first and foremost.
I learned a lot on Government Day. You know, it used to be, when I think of government, I think of us and them. And after meeting the people in political offices and hearing what they do, I see it as we now. I can make a difference. I don't have to hold an office, but they're really looking out for what's best for us, and they do care what happens.
I would have to say Business and Economic Development Day. It really helped me understand in greater depth the relationships, the ecosystem that we all work within, and how one thing affects another, either directly or indirectly.
I think that the day that we did criminal and law enforcement, that was a great day just to see what a great program we've put together in Thurston County for the drug courts, and how we're doing such a great job of lifting people up as they're getting clean and sober, and then bringing them back into the program to help mentor others.
I had almost no idea of the alternative court system in Thurston County, the drug courts, the family courts. I was really moved by the stories that folks told of people who had gone through those processes, and it was great to learn about how those alternative court systems are making the justice system more just.
The day that the cops came and spoke and you got to see how much passion they had for the work they do and the challenges that they're facing in this time really like opened my eyes to things.
I really enjoyed the poverty simulator. Very eye-opening. Really gives you a chance to see what it's like if your circumstances change or a couple of missteps and how much it can affect your daily life, you know, and some of the decisions you have to make.
One of the things that I'll never forget is the poverty simulation. Doing that just made me realize how difficult it is to gain access to services for people, and also just even down to transportation, getting a job. So I'll never forget that experience.
It changed one of the things that I want to be involved in, which is Quixote Village. I loved getting to see a very impactful and sustainable system that is working regarding homelessness.
I think I'm definitely prompted to be more involved in our community, and it's really opened up the various options that are available.
As I look at my job and look at how I interact and the decisions I make for, you know, my department within MultiCare and within the hospital itself, I'm more mindful of the impact that that has, whether it be creation of jobs or impact on the economy or just impact on the residents. It's definitely planted a seed that sits there in the decision-making processes.
It made me realize that when we come together as a community, we can do a lot more to help each other out.
If I could wave a magic wand, I will make sure that no one in my community is without food, shelter, or healthcare.
I would like to see the end to the overall housing crisis in our community, which includes housing availability, having affordable housing, and everything that's causing the homelessness crisis in our community.
I know it's a very complex issue, but if I could wave a magic wand over the people that are living on the street and make them happy and healthy, engaged members of society, I think that would probably be my first choice.
Yeah, if I had a magic wand, I think I would take all the mental health doctors and providers and like multiply it by like 100 and just make sure everyone has the necessary access and support for what they need.
My magic wand would to help take care of our community members with mental health issues. I believe that is the base of a lot of our crisis in our communities, and if we could help with the mental health, that would help with drug addictions, homelessness, a lot of it. A lot of our veterans need that help too. So that would be my magic wand wish.
I would significantly increase the funding for schools because I see a huge teacher shortfall, and I constantly hear from educators in the community how we're lacking resources and it's affecting our children.
If we could get equity for everybody, where everybody has the chance to succeed no matter what their situation is in life, that would be just to give everybody that fair, equal opportunity to make a good life.
Definitely enforcing people to be active community members to help with collaboration and preventing silos.
I think the one thing that I would change is just tolerance. I think for everyone in our community to just be more tolerant with people, and have more respect for people. I think that we would all be able to get along much better and just understand that everyone has differences and that it's okay to tolerate those differences.
There are so many things that need assistance, from the environment to housing, education, mental health, you name it. But I think the one thing that we're missing is just communication with folks who are on the opposite end of the aisle. And I think if we can all just have courageous conversations with one another, we can work together to address these problems, even when we are at complete odds with each other in terms of our beliefs.
This program has been one of the best experiences of my life. I'm so grateful that my director suggested that I participate. to see, you know, on scene day, to travel and get to see little nooks of the community that I've never had the opportunity to see, and talk to small business owners and hear what they need and what their concerns are. I think it really exceeded my expectations, and I got to know a lot of great people and built connections I'll have for a lifetime.
No, it's just been fantastic for a new guy heading here from Florida that didn't know all of the interactions and interconnectedness of the community. It was just wonderful to see how this community operates, the wonderful folks in LTC that are bringing us together, and just the ability to get to know those folks making a difference in the community.
If you get the opportunity to apply for LTC, I would say it's one of the best decisions I've made this year as a professional, and personally as well. I've received so much back from this program professionally and personally.
The program was more impactful to me than I thought it would be. The relationships that we were able to form with other people in the community. As an adult, I don't know about you, but it's hard to find to make friends, and being in this environment kind of helped forge those bonds and those relationships, and I think I'll have some friendships that last a really long time.
I've never seen a program like this. I actually work up north in King County now, and they do not have something similar. I think it is hands down one of the best things that Washington State and Thurston County have to offer. And I would recommend anybody that's in a professional capacity to go and do this class. It's more like a master's degree than something else.